Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. Hope you all are doing absolutely fine. So today we'll be continuing with our FMT exam revision series with our next topic, treatment of snake poison. The main principles of treatment include allaying anxiety and frights, prevention of the spread of venom, use of antivenom and other antitoxic therapy, general measures. Allaying anxiety and fright. The patient should be reassured by pointing out that all snakes are not poisonous. Even poisonous snakes are not fully charged with poison, and even a snake fully charged with poison cannot always inject a lethal dose. Prevention of spread venom. Spread of snake venom throughout the body is mostly by diffusion and lymph circulation. Therefore, efforts to reduce lymph circulation are helpful, and this can be achieved by immobilization, application of tourniquet, cleansing the wound, and incision and suction. Antivenin. It is of two kinds, either specific or polyvalent. Specific antivenin is prepared by hyperimmunizing horses against the venom of particular snake, while polyvalent antivenin is prepared by hyperimmunizing horses against the venom of four common poisonous snakes, namely cobra, common crate, Russell's viper, and saw-scaled viper. When antivenin is not available, local infiltrations of carbolic soap around the site of the bite in case of elapid snakes and heparin in case of vipers is recommended. General measures. Stimulants are helpful in paralytic case and artificial respiration is often required. Transfusion of whole blood may be helpful in hemorrhagic cases. Steroids are effective in combating the allergic manifestations of antivenin therapy. Aspirin, short-acting, barbiturates and antibiotic prophylaxis is combat secondary infection together with general supportive measures are beneficial. A patient bitten by an elapid snake, if not dead in 2 hours, will probably recover rapidly and completely. A patient bit by a viper is in danger for much longer time and convalescence is very protracted. Thank you.